महालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्ते नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्गणेशाय नमो। वयं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम प्रतिष्ठानं बुद्धिबुद्धिं बुद्धेर् पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महा तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रेणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाश मोक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Just go to the Tippana where the Drishti Srishti Vada as established by Sri Valmiki also as the Tatparya of the Shruti has been explained here. So yat sankoch vikasabhyam jagat pralay srushteha nishta vedant vakyanam atha vacham gocharaha. So we know that the same consciousness manifests in the form of the prapancha. So whether you take it as an individual consciousness or at the universal level, there is no difference. Consciousness is but one. Therefore, Jagat Pralaya Srushti is just by the manifestation and unmanifestation of the Satchidananda Brahma Tattva, which is same as Atma. Nishtha Vedanta Vakyanam, and that's the commitment of the Tatparya Nishtha of the Shruti, Vedanta Vakya, Upanishad Vakyas, and it is Agochara to the Indriyas and Manaha. Pratitikattvam Vedanta Siddhante Jagatasputam Atasuptau Jagallinam Prabodhe Jayate Punaha Drishti Srishtim Imam Brahmanubhavi. I really don't know what this is. Vadumanyate. Baddho Mukto Mahavidwan Ajna Ityadi Bhedataha. So I wanted to look this up, but then I forgot. Anyway, Eka Eva Sadabhati Naneva Swapnavat Swayam Atas Swayupta Ye Vanye Sham Abhasanam Apidhruvam. Okay, so what is the word? Somebody said something. Bahumanyate. Okay, thank you. Yeah, so I just wanted, maybe it is there in the errata. I didn't check that up. I had marked it, but then I had not marked it. I forgot due to that reason. So Bahumanyate. Okay, thank you. So Eka Eva Sadabhati Naneva Swapnavat Swayam Atas Swayuttaye Vanyesham Abhasanam Apidhruvam Muktim Janati He Deva Atmana Yatma Vidvaraha Swasamsara Dashayam Tu Swabhrantya Sarvadehinam Abhasanam Cha Samsaram Veda Yuktim Tathaiva Cha Tuchha Anirvachaniya Cha Vastavi Cha Ityasau Tridha Neyamaya Trivir Bodhaihi Shrota Yukti Laukikaihi Iti. So anyway, a lot of references have been given. We saw the first. So Pratitikattvam Vedanta Siddhante Jagatasputam. There is clear appearance of the Prapancha, but in Vedanta Siddhanta, what is it? It is the same Chaitanya which is manifesting, just like Atha Suptau Jagallinam Prabodhe Jayate Punaha. Just like Nitya Pralaya, so is the entire Prapancha also the Waker's consciousness. Mandukya explains that in the Waker's consciousness, the entire Prapancha is resolved, including the Samashti, not only the Vyashti. Vyashti, Samashti, both are resolved into the Vishwa. and this Vishwa is resolved into the Taijasa, the dreamer, and the Taijasa along with the dream world, including Hiranyagarbha, is resolved into Prajna, and along with Ishvara, and the Prajna along with Ishvara, who is the Sushupti Avastha Abhimani at the Samashti level. Sorry. So he is, Ishvara is also resolved into the Brahma Tattva, which is called as Turiya, where there is no Bheda at the Vyashti and Samashti level. So Jagal Leenam Prabhode Jayate Punaha, just like the entire Prapancha, Swapna Prapancha is resolved, similarly the Jagrat Prapancha is also resolved. So it is the same consciousness which cannot be differentiated at the Vyashti and Samashti level, into which the entire Prapancha is resolved, and it wakes up with the waker. Although it is said Supto in one who is sleeping. So stepwise you can understand that it is into the dreamer and then into the deep sleeper, but then it is all the same consciousness in the end. Drishti Srishti Imam Brahmanubhavi Bahumanyate. So Bahumanyate, Brahmanubhavi, one who has Brahmanubhava, Brahmanubhavasya Astiti Brahmanubhavi. This is considered as Drishti Srishti Vada. Baddho Mukto Mahavidwan Ajna Ityadi Bhedataha. One who has a drishti of the srishti and considers it that it as real, is a baddha. One who does not consider it as real is a mukta, is a Mahavidwan also. Whereas baddha is ajna. So these bhedas are there. There can be differentiation made at many levels, but then it is understanding this Swapna example where the Prapancha is resolved, Jagrat Prapancha is resolved during the dream, and it comes back during the dream or during deep sleep. Any example can be taken, but then the comparison made is Swapnavat Mithya. Jagat is Swapnavat Mithya, and that is the main example for Drishti Srishti Vada. Eka Eva Sada Bhati Nana Iva Swapnavat Swayam. So that is Swapnavat Mithya. The entire Swapna Prapancha along with the subject and all the objects, sentient or insentient, including the Pancha Mahabhutas and their Karyas, including the Surya, why Surya, even the Karma Phaladata Ishvara there in the Swapna, is not the Ishvara that we know in waking, then who is that Ishvara who is giving me a Karma Phala? If a person is suffering in dream, the dreamer, he may say that this is my Karma Phala. Who is giving that Karma Phala? We can say it's the same Ishvara who pervades the waking and dream state, but then at that particular point in that Swapna Karma, which is imagined by the sleeper, one who is sleeping, the Karma Phala Jata is also equally imagined by that entity, including the entire setup, the entire avastha, whatever pratiti is there, all that is a kalpana. And similarly, it can be extended to the Jagrat Avastha. It need not be an individualized consciousness. The individualization itself is mithya. That itself is Swapnavat. Therefore, we need not feel that this is blasphemy. So, Swapnavat Swayam Nana Iva Bhati Sada. Swayam shows you Swabhavataha. The swabhava of Chaitanya is to appear in various ways. That is its very swabhava. As soon as there is something to be cognized, there is a variety. As soon as there is bheda, due to ajnana, as soon as the ajnana is there, which is ever there, unless it is countered by jnana, there is continuous pratiti. That continuous pratiti of variety is the swabhava of Chaitanya. Devasya esha swabhava, says Bhagavan Karikakara. That is swayam here, eka eva. And ekaiva sada. Sada says that even in the pratiti kala, that ekaha remains ekaha. And as ataha so yuttaye va anyesham abhasanapi dhruvam muktim janati he deva atmana hyatma vidvaraha sva samsara dashayam tu svabhrantya sarva dehinam. So, Atmana hi Atma Vidvaraha. The Atma Vidvara, the Atma Vit. And Vara in that. Atma Vit, who is Vara? Superior. There are gradations of jnanis. One who is an Atma Vit, a superior Atma Vit, Atmana Muktim Janati. He knows by oneself, he knows the Mukti. There is nothing else needed. After neti neti prakriya, after you take away everything, what you know is your own swarupa without anything in between. That is called as aparoksha jnana, because it is immediate without anyone mediating, anything or anyone mediating. There is nothing else involved. The antakkarana is also resolved cognitively. Sukshma sharira is resolved because the karana sharira is gone, is countered. There is ajnana lesha, all right, but then it is not strong enough to make the vikshepa seem like real. Thereby atmavit varaha. And it is bhati. For everyone it appears. Nana eva it appears. But the atmavit varaha knows that it is a pratiti matra and it is swayam sada bhati, it is swapnavat mithya. So he knows that. Swasamsara dashayam tu swabhrantya sarvadehinam. So this, you know, anvaya is across shloka. So if you go into details, you have to see bhati. So bhati is the only word which appears here. Janati is another word. But swasamsara dashayam tu swabhrantya. You can say janati also, but sarvadehi naam swabhrantya, this is important, swabhrantya. It is not real. Samsara dasha is itself due to bhranti, which is due to avidya. And that is, if taken as real, then there is no mukti. Then he is an ajna and therefore baddha. As soon as he knows that it is pratiti matra and swapnavat, sadabhati, then muktim janati. He knows that I am ever free and therefore mukta, being a mahavidvan. Sorry. Therefore, atma vidvaraha. Or there can be parsh, you know, this half and this half can be taken together. So context has to be seen, but then the entire yoga vasishta is like that. You look at even Laghu Yoga Vasishta, you have to read the in its entirety and make sense out of it. Abhasanam cha samsaram veda yuktim tathaiva cha tuchha anirvachaniya cha vastavi cha ityasau tridha neya maya tribhir bodhaihi shrauta yauktika laukikaihi iti. So you see, it starts with half the verse here, it ends with another half here. Not with the full verse. The full verse has this dual danda. So there is, you have to look at each and every verb and see how is the anvaya. So if you look at the last year, swasamsara dasyam tu swabhrante sarvadehinam abhasanam cha samsaram veda. So this can be taken as a verb there, swabhrantya veda. Yuktim tathaiva cha. Tuchha, and then you see here tuchha. Anirvachaniya cha vastavi cha ityasau tridhad. Maya is tuchha, anirvachaniya, vastavi. This is the threefold differences there. Niya, maya, it should be known so. Tribhir bodhahi shrauta yuktika laukikahi. Then again the shruti, yukti and laukika, other pramanas can be used to understand this. Laukikaihi vastavi jneya maya. Maya, laukika saying that maya is vastavi, she is real. And therefore the entire maya karya is also real. When you use yukti, then you know it is anirvachaniya. Why? Because in yukti, you cannot say it is sat or asat. So sadasadbhyam anirvachaniya is through yukti. So shruti pramana, it is actually tuchha. Parmarthika drishtya. Shruti perspective is parmarthika drishti. In Brahma, there is no maya. Maya is inferred. Karyanumeya maya. In Viveka Chudamani, Bhagavan Shankaracharya says this. What is maya? Maya is inferred due to the karya, which cannot be from a nirguna brahma, from the nirguna brahma. Therefore, maya is tuchha in brahma, but inferable from the vyavaharika perspective. So, shruti perspective, shrauta, the shrauta perspective is that maya is tuchha. This is not acceptable to many, but then that is a fact. Therefore, we say, okay, vyavaharika, it has vyavaharika satya, which is anirvachaniya. Vyavaharika satya means mithya. But for laukika, who is a completely baddha, who is a samsari, who is involved in the karya, who is driven by raga dvesha, for all of them, maya is vastavi. They may not even know the term maya, but it is vastavi. Everything is real. Anyway, so that is the quotation given for Drishti Srishtivada and related things there. So we have to begin with 230th Avarta. Drishtantatvena Raja Amatya Bharchu Katha Prastavaha. So there are Drishtanta given. And as an example, a story is given. I'm going to speed up through the story, not go word by word. Just give me one moment, please. So here, Bharchoho Swadhikara Bhramshaha. So Bharcho is the Amatya, a minister of a king. So here it is said, He Somya, Dvaita Vachananu Smaranam, Dhrudatara Prachina Advaita Anubhava Samskara Janya, Janyam Ati Dhridam Api Advaita Smritim Pratibadnati. This was mentioned earlier. Even the Smriti of Dvaita binds and binds whom? Even one who has Advaita Samskara. So, just the Dvaita Vachananu Smaranam, Nama Rupa Smaranam itself, Dhridatara Prachina Advaita Anubhava Samskara Janyam Atidradham Api Advaita Smritim. We have seen that Ajnana counters jnana. It is virodharte nany. So the dvaita vachana, anusmarana of dvaita vachana tells you that ajnana has not gone completely. If it has not gone completely, whereby there is this karya and smriti of that karya also as real, then even if the advaita samskara is strong enough, but still, I mean, it's strong, but is not strong enough to take away ajnana completely, then what will happen? Even if it is strong, drudatara, stronger than earlier, it is growing strong, but still one is indulging in dvaita, then what will happen is that it will, ajnana samskara will grow more, the dvaita samskara will grow more, and then even the advaita samskara being dridatara, still if the ajnana grows stronger, the dvaita vachananu smarana causes the ajnana and ajnana karya to grow stronger, then it will counter jnana further. It will block the jnana further. It will place obstacles. And thereby, what is the resultant? Tattva sakshatkaram duri karoti. Iti cha iti upapadayitum kanchana katham prastavmiti bharchu katham guru shishyam prati kathayati. So guru gives this example story to drive home this point that how the dvaita samskara smarana, even for a jnani, can place obstacles. And when we say jnani, we talk about jnani matra. There are gradations in jnani. We are not talking about someone whose ajnana has been completely taken away. So, one who is a jnani matra, he knows, but then manana may not be complete. Even if manana is complete, the nishtha is not complete because there are a lot of vasanas. The purva vasanas are placing obstacles and they are manifesting in the form of raga dvesha, into that samsara created by raga dvesha, one has a fall because unto advaita brahmatma there is no nishtha. Therefore, tattva sakshatkaram duri karoti. This same anusmarana, just the anusmarana of following the dvaita, which was there already. It's already sitting in memory, it is there, and one recalls that, you know, those were the good days or bad days, whatever it is, starting there and then has a fall. For that, this Bharchukata, who is an amatya for Raja, that is said here. Asit kasichid rajnyo bharchur nama pradhanamatya. This amatya is a prime minister, such a swayatti krita sakala rajya karyaha abhavat. He used to take care of everything. So an important minister that way. Tasya prabhavam drishtvetare rajopa jivanaha tasmin irshalavaha sanjataha. Tathapi rajnyo niratishaya premaspadi bhutaya bharchave na apakartum ashakan. So others were jealous of him, but then Raja was very attached to this minister who was committed to his job. And then he didn't take action against him anyway. He used to consider him as, you know, as his right hand rather. Tadate sangi bhuya bharchu nirasano upayam alochya rahasi tad rashtrasthan dasyun lunthanaya prerayamasuhu. So the other ministers who were jealous of this amatya bharchu, what they came together and they said that it's in our benefit that you know, we do something about this. So they conspired against him. And in the conspiracy, they thought that, you know, let us create some kind of a situation, havoc, which is what we see in, you know, in India also these days. Create some disturbance because you are against someone. So these fellows did the same thing. So it is not a new trick or anything. This has been going on forever. Of course, this idea is, the story is cooked up, but then it is cooked up because there is some basis. All these things, you know, were there forever at various levels. So what happened is that they created, they went in touch with some, you know, miscreants, and then some robbers and looters. They asked them to create some disturbance in the kingdom. So they start dasyubhi luntite rashtre. So when the rashtra, the kingdom, was troubled with all the loot, robbery and loot that is going on, then so sati saptami raja rashtrasya sahasopanat upaplavam shrutva sabham sammelya tatrasthan mukhyadhikarinah dasyuvidravanaya niyojayama. So what the raja has to do? He called a meeting, a sabha, and then said that somebody has to do something about this. So we have to work on this. We have to eliminate this nuisance. Now, who is going to do this? Somebody has to do this. So there, te sarve, the other ministers who were against Bharchu, sangibhuya, they already come together. So together they said, Rajanam evam avochan, Swamin sada bharchum bhavan shlagate apatkale cha asman niyojayati. He says, why do you ask us what is to be done now? Every time you favor Bharchu, why don't you ask him what should be done? Why shouldn't he do something about it? Because, you know, they say that you are favoring Bharchu, why don't you ask him? Kimityasau bharchuridanim na niyujyate, why don't you ask him to go and take care of this problem? Iti chirta etaj bharchuhu sanjali rajanam aha. And Bharchu said that okay, he folded hands, he told the Raja, Swamin yadi ajnapyate tarhi asminneva kshane gatva ripun jitva agamishyami iti. He says that if you just give me an order, I'll take care of the situation. Tarhi tathaiva kriyatam iti raja bharchum ajnapayan chakara. And what did he say? The Raja said, okay, you go ahead and take care of the issue. If you are so confident, just solve this. Then what Bharchu did? Bharchurapi tatshanam eva shatrun vidravya rajye sasyadikam samraksha sarvesham kshemam atanot. Bharchu did what he had to do. He took care of the issue. He fought with them. He won over them. And he protected all the resources of the kingdom. Bharchur jayam shutva itare rajapurushaha yuddhe bharchu mrutaha iti rajanam avideyasu. Now, the entire setup was such that they wanted these robbers to, all the others wanted the robbers to kill Bharchu. That was the idea. That's why they instigated everything and they asked the Raja to send Bharchu. Unfortunately for them, Bharchu was stronger than all the robbers put together. And he won them over. They didn't expect this to happen. Now what should they do? Their plan failed. Instead, what they did is that Bharchur Jayam Shrutva, they heard that Bharchu won, but then they lied to the Raja. Itare Raja Purusha Yudhe Bharchu Mrutaha. virtue died in the battle, said these ministers to Raja. Ichi Rajanam Avedayasu. Of course, the king does not know. He has not seen anything, but then he trusts his ministers. He thought that virtue is dead. Now, Viveka Vikalo Raja, the Raja who is bereft of Viveka. This is the Ajnani's case. Ajnani does not have Viveka. Tesham Yalika Vachanam Vishwasya Bharchustane Teshu Anyatamam Niyujya Tasmai Shibika Chhatra Chamaradi Virudam Cha Kalpayamasa Nutano Mantri Yatha Bharchur Narashtram Agachet यथा च राज्ञः स्वप्नेऽपि भर्तृज्ञानं न स्यात् तथा यथा च राज्ञः स्वप्नेऽपि भर्तृज्ञानं न स्यात् तथा उपायशतैः संविधानं अकरोत्. So now this, you have to imagine that the battle is going on elsewhere, and these guys brought this story to the Raja. The Raja thought that, okay, Bharchu is dead, but I need some prime minister. So he appointed a new minister. The new minister is one of them who already knows what has to be done. So what he did is, he did not allow Bharchu to get inside the kingdom really. He threw him. I mean, somehow Bharchu was not allowed to get back into the kingdom. And yathacha rajnya swapne api bharchujnanam nasyat. And so many things were done so that Raja forgets Bharchu. Tatha upayashatehi samvidhanam akarot. And so on, they continued to do that. The minister, the replacement minister, took all the action such that the Raja forgets Bharchu. Now, what is Bharchu supposed to do? Bharchu ho sanyasaha. Bharchu is anyway outside the kingdom. And then, Bharchu ho akhilam imam nyatva evam achintayat. So, Bharchu came to know what is going on. He said that anyway, I can't get into the kingdom. I have no access to the king. He knew about the conspiracy. He stayed out. Na idanim mama raja nikatam gantum uchitam. Because he knows that there is conspiracy going on. And anyway, he has no access to the king or anyone. He can't trust anyone. So if he goes back to the kingdom, it would be foolishness. Yaha aham arogena dridhena गात्रेण अविकलैः इन्द्रियैश्च सम्पन्नः सर्वभोगोपकरण भरितेषु रम्येषु हर्म्येषु निवसन् स्वलावण्यावधीर् स्वलावण्यावधीर् ईरितापसरोभिः कामिनीभिः अनवरतं रममाणो दिव्यान् भोगान् भुञ्जान एव कालम एतावन्तम अनयम. सो ही इज अपसेट नाउ. ही सिंग्स दैट द एंटायर टाइम इन द किंगडम दैट आई स्पेंड फॉर द सेक ऑफ द किंग द किंगडम एंड बीइंग अ मिनिस्टर विथ लॉट ऑफ रिसोर्सेस प्राइम मिनिस्टर विथ लॉट ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. He says that I have enjoyed thoroughly. So aroga, dridha aroga, a healthy life that I have had, I have spent in luxury. And luxury with all sorts of indulgences. That's what it means. He has, with all sorts of indulgences, in artha and kama, he has spent his life. Of course, with dharma of protecting the kingdom as a kshatriya maybe, but otherwise he has spent his life in artha and kama. So he thought about it now. Tasya me maranaanta vipadidanim apatita. And even with this kind of a life, I have still found myself outside the kingdom. No? Such difficulty has befallen me. Jingva murkham yantam kalam bhangureshu bhogeshu nimagnam. So he had vairagya. So Bhartrari also same. Bhartrari's vairagya shatakam is similar. So this story may be inspired from Bhartrari's vairagya shatakam. So we have lost time. This is the thinking that he has. I have spent my time in useless bhogas. I have not given any time to Shreyo Marga. Matsama ko anyosti mudaha ityekante stitva yabhir mohita etavantam kalam Shreyo Marga duri krutaha abhut tasamanganam pratyekamanganam atyantam ashobhanatam अशोभनता मति जुगुप्सावहता दारापत्य धनादीनाम अनधिक दुख निदानतांच भूयो भूयो अनुचिंतयन भोगाद विरतः तपस्वी संबभूव. सो ही थॉट दैट आई हैव स्पेंट टाइम इन मूढ़ता. Thereby, I have not given importance to Shreyo Marga. The Shreyo Marga is far away. Moksha Bhauduram. That is the case. That is my lot now. And on the Artha and Kama side, anyway, I have lost it. They have thrown me out. So he thinks that the entire life, even with multiple wives, dharapatya dhanadina, all this was completely useless. Again and again he has thought about it. And thereby, bhogat virataha had vairagya tapasvi sambhavuva. He started doing tapah. So he became a tapasvi. Bharchoho vairagya varananam. So what kind of vairagya did he have? So we know the ideas of vairagya. We have seen in a lot of works earlier. So it is mentioned as to each and every part now, because, and especially because he is a man, the vairagya, just like in Bhartrari's vairagya shataka, it may come off as offensive to women. But you should look at the flip side also. It is equally true from a woman's perspective, for vairagya to be generated. It need not be really so exactly in those words. There can be some exaggeration to build up vairagya. So you have to think about it in that manner. Paradhina seva dukkha hetuhu ekante sukham. So now there are a lot of things. One of the things talked about is a woman. In a manner that vairagya has to be generated. So what all does he think about here? Paradhina seva dukkha hetuhu. The cause for dukkha is seva, which is paradhina. This is a dependence on another. So here ekante sukham. There is sukha in ekanta. Ekanta vasa. There is no dependency. Either way, there is no dependency. Nana vichitrasaihi supajya shalyanna shaka dadhi dhruta payasa apupa adi aneka prakarehi annapanadivihi api truptim anapannam imam jivham etavantam kalam vrutha poshitavan asmi. First, he starts with the tongue, you know. The tongue is unfortunately an input as well as an output. It has a taste and it can blabber, which you call as a foot and the mouth disease. So there is difficult to control. So you bite your tongue, but then how do you take care of the taste for something? So nana vichitra rasas is used to so many things, and it is not only in this janma, across janmas there is some vasana, taste for something. So example uses the tongue here. So this jivha etavanta vrutha poshitavan asmi, I have just indulged in this taste organ. Itah param na tritha imam jivham pushniyam, now I am grown wiser, he thinks that. This is the bharchu vairagya prakara. Kshudam shamayitum kinna santi vane vividhani kanda moola shaka phaladini. To sustain myself, there are so many things available. Shaka phala are there in the vana also. I can stay here and sustain myself with that. Pipasa upashamanaya kinna santi vimala jalaha saritaha saritaha tadakani cha. And there are water resources also. So hunger and thirst I should not worry about. Nivasaya harmya talad api atishayitaha vata tapa varshad janupadruta guhaha kinna santi. For shelter also I have caves. Pradesha matrodara puranaya kimanaya shravrtya rajasevaya. So I don't need to serve the king to sustain myself. There are so many things that I can do and stay in the forest itself and be happy. There is no reason to have dependency on the kingdom itself. Mama idanim patravane prithvi shayya bahu upabarahu kandamuladin yaharaha nirmalodaka panapatram cha anjali reva. And to drink, I need no patra even. I can drink using my hands, putting together my hands. It can become a vessel and I can drink water. I have ahara. All these are available. Tatha cha uktam bhagavate. And then bhagavata is quoted here. Satyangshitau kim kashipov prayasair baho swasiddhe kyupabarhanai kim satyanjalau kim purudhanna patrya digvalkaladau satikim dukulaihi. So same thing is paraphrased by the sadhu here from Bhagavata. So there is grass to lie down on, which can serve as a bed. So shayya is there, prithvi shayya vane. And do I need pillows also? No, I don't need my bahus. Upabarho, they can serve as pillows. So these ideas are there here in the Bhagavata also. You don't need anything else. And sati anjalau kim purudhanna patra patrya. What use is there? I don't need to look for a vessel. I have, it may not be, the way it was there in the kingdom. There are no silver spoons here. But then still, it will serve the purpose. Chirani kim patina santi dishanti bhiksham naivangripa naivangripa parabhrita saritopyashushyan ruddha guha kim ajino vati no pasannan kasmad bhajanti kavayo dhana durmadandhan iti. And further the other things that he has gathered from Bhagavate, tathachoktam Bhagavate, he says, guhas are there. I can stay in the guha also. So shelter also, I don't need the palace. So everything is given in nature. Everything is given by Ishvara in nature. And which is what we, in moderners say that. Everything is available free in nature to take care of the needs. Unfortunately, the resources are not sufficiently given to meet everyone's greed. needs are met. The greed cannot be met. Let alone greeds. Even a single person's greed cannot be met by the entire prapancha. And everyone has greed. Definitely the resources are not going to be sufficient. So, itham bharchuhu vicharayan vishaya bhogeshu nana doshan drushtva ekanta sthite eva paramananda pradipakattvam nirachanchinot. So, bharchuhu thought about all this and then he had vairagya. Ekanta sthitehe eva paramananda pradipakattvam nirachinot. In ekanta vasa, in sannyasa itself, there is sukha, ananda, ekante sukhamasti. In vishayabhoga, there are nana doshas. Stri putra dhanadinam dukkhan nidanattvam ekanta sthitehe sukhahetuttvam cha bharchur yatha nischikaya tatha idanim varnyate. And then how did he land on vairagya about each and everything? That is mentioned here. Ekanta sevinaha sarva bhaumadi brahma paryantananda labha. So one who is an ekanta sevi, meaning he does not want any other upadi sukha. He does not want any other bhoga. So this is paraphrased from Taittiriya Upanishad Brahmananda Valli. So gradations of ananda are talked about with each upadhi, each better upadhi, one gets hundredfold ananda. 100 is just a number. And one who has vairagya towards that kind of ananda in a higher upadhi, which is hundredfold, that kind of a person gets ananda here in this upadhi itself. Just because of vairagya. Because of not being a wanting person, the desire lacking, ananda is not having any obstacles. One does not face any obstacles to ananda and thereby has sukha, which is more than the upadhi, equivalent to the higher upadhi, ananda, which is said to be hundredfold. So that is mentioned here. Tatahi. We'll see this in the next part. Huh? All the gradations with each upadhi are mentioned here. We'll quickly go through this because they are just listings of various upadhis up to Hiranyagarbha Padvi. So Hiranyagarbha, up to Hiranyagarbha upadhi, there is at each upadhi level, each stage, there is hundredfold sukha. Starting with a Manushya Ananda, which is a unit of ananda of a Manushya, who is an emperor of the entire prapancha, the entire wealth is his. He is trained in dharma also. He is young enough to have all the bhoga. So all the best aspects are brought in into a single person who is an ideal, which can never be the case. Hypothetically, if such a person existed, then what would be his ananda? Which itself is impossible to attain, and that is called as one unit of Manushya Ananda. And then hundredfold Ananda is the next Upadhi Ananda. So the one unit of Ananda itself is not attainable by any human being, impossibility. But still it is taken as a supposition, and then the gradations are described to glorify Vairagya. So we'll look at this in the next part. Sukhan nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namuk adhisthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher dhrakyatva nirmanam aparam sarvedanta vedyam pratyak paramaha tadevaha namattonyat iti me nishchitamatihi. Namaste.
Hari Om.
So this is what I meant by going a little fast. I don't want to go through each line, analyze verbs and all that. So we get the story, we get the idea. So it's a broader perspective so that we can go to Vedanta part sooner. Namaste.
Hello. Thank you.